Hi guys, it's LaContra. Welcome to Fashion Illustration 101 with me. Before I start this tutorial, please like, share and subscribe. Hit the notification bell so that you get more notifications when more videos are released. So far, we've treated the basic forms, how to draw the basic forms and how to shade the basic forms to look 3D. Today, I want to talk to you guys about the relationship between the basic forms and the human figure, okay? Anything you want to draw can be broken down into the basic forms, okay, including the human body. The first thing you should know about the human figure is that the human figure is 3D. The human figure has height, depth, and width, okay? That is why when you look at the body, okay, although you are seeing the front, but you know there's something else at the back. Why? Because the human is not flat. The human body is 3D, okay? This is the side view, okay? That is why you can look all around. This is a three-quarter view of the human figure. And this is the back view, okay? So the human figure is 3D. It has height, it has width, and it has depth. The depth is what makes you to see the side and the figure from the top, the bottom, and what have you. Okay? It is important for you to know the relationship between forms and human figure because this will help you see the human figure as 3D even when you are drawing them. Okay? Although there's a simplified method I'm going to be showing you later on how to draw human figure, but you still have to know this, okay, so that you can draw them better, you can understand the human form better. Why drawing the human form? Why draw the human body? You need to draw the human body because a garment, a dress needs a body, okay? Without a body, then you cannot design a dress or a garment. So drawing body is just as important as drawing garments. So back to where we stopped, back to the relationship between forms and human body. So looking at the human figure, which forms do you see evident here? Okay, there are three major forms that relate to the human body: the sphere, the cylinder, and the cube. The sphere, cylinder, and the cube. Okay. So before we start talking about how they relate to the human body, we're going to be talking about modified forms, okay? So now, this is a cube right here. It's quite symmetrical, okay? You can see all sides. And I drew through so that you see the sides are not visible. And look at this cube here. It looks irregular, okay? So here we have a modified cube. This is a modified cube, but this is a regular cube. But the basic form is still a cube. Likewise, the cylinder, this is a symmetrical cylinder, quite geometric. And this is a modified cylinder. But that basic form of cylinder is still evident here and here. Okay? Same thing with the sphere. You can see the ellipse. Okay? This is another sphere looking like an ovoid shape. And this is another sphere looking like an egg shape. Okay, so these are all modified. These are modified sphere, but the basic form is still a sphere. Now let's talk about the head. Okay, the human head is basically a sphere. Okay, this is a sphere and it's a modified sphere, just like the egg shape. Okay, when you make the tip of the egg, the jaw is like the tip of the egg, and this is the wider part of the egg here. So this is the front view. It's a spherical shape. It sits on a neck, and the neck is a cylinder shape. Okay? This is the head from back view. Okay? The broken line indicates the jawline, although you cannot see the jawline from the back view. This is the side view. You can see the egg is tilted. It's not straight like the back and front view. It's kind of tilted this way, but you can see that basic ellipse to show you it's a 3D shape, and you can see the neck is still a cylinder. Okay, the head is a spherical shape, sitting on the neck, and the neck is a cylinder form. Okay, now we have other parts of the body that conform to the sphere. Okay, we have the breasts, and the breast is a sphere, okay, that has been sliced into two. Okay, you can see this sphere sliced into two. From the side view, that is how the breast looks like. That's the form of the bust, okay, from the side view. And if you look at the bust from the front view of a figure, this is what you are going to see. It's going to appear like this. But this is the basic form, a sliced sphere, okay? So it's still a spherical shape. That form is still evident. Even the bum, okay, the butt, is still a spherical shape that has been sliced and even modified the more, okay? It's almost similar to the bust, just that there is no black patch here to indicate nipple, okay? So the form, the spherical form is still there for the head, the bust, and the butt. Okay, so let's talk about the torso. The torso is the upper part of the body. Torso, okay? You can see the basic form here. This is a cylinder. Another cylinder down here for the lower torso. And you can see how I drill through this cylinder to have that feeling of three dimension. Okay, this is the upper torso here, and this is the lower torso here. This is the hip, the pelvis. Okay, you can see this cylinder shape here. This is where the thigh fits into the lower torso at the ball and socket joint. Okay, so it's the torso is basically cylinder shape, cylinder form, I meant to say. Okay, these are the legs. Okay, this is the thigh. Okay, you can see the thigh is a modified cylinder. This part of the thigh is where it's going to fit. It fits in here. Okay, and this part of the thigh is where you have the knee joint. Okay, it joins to this part of the calf. Okay, this is the calf, another modified cylinder, and here fits in here. Okay, so you can see the leg is a modified cylinder here. I drew the leg bent as if the figure is sitting down. Okay, you can see the thigh, modified cylinder, and here represent the kneecap. Okay, so when I want to do the full drawing, I just have to draw the kneecap like so. Okay, but the basic form is still cylinder. While for the foot, okay, look at the foot, it's like a wedge shape, a modified cube for the foot here and here. Let's talk about the arm. Okay, so this is the upper arm. This is the deltoid. This here in front is the bicep, and at the back here is the tricep. But it's still a modified cylinder. Okay, you can see the lower arm. Okay, this is where the elbow connects. The upper arm and the lower arm, they connect, and the elbow is at the back here. But you can see that it's still a modified cylinder. Still a modified cylinder. And you can see the arm is bent here, okay, and the elbow is supposed to be here. And you can see the hands. Okay, let's talk about the hands. The hand is a wedge shaped, a modified cube. Okay, you can see the hand. The position of the hand here is when you do this. Okay, you know, when you do this on the table, this is the part of the hand you're seeing. You can see that cube, the basic form. Okay, that is this. And you can see the hand when it's bent like this, and here when the arm is bent like so. Okay, you can see that modified cube shape. Okay, you should know these forms very well because they will help you understand the body. Okay, so that'll be all for now. So I'm going to say you should practice drawing these forms very well. Be very familiar with them because they would really help you in drawing anything at all if you know the basic form of that thing you want to draw. Okay, so let's do a recap. The human form is a 3D figure. Okay, it has height, it has width, it has depth. Okay, you can see the front side view. Okay, you can see the back view. Okay, because the form is a 3D figure. figure. We also talk about modified forms. We talk about modified cylinder, modified cube, modified sphere. Okay, and we said the modified sphere can be used to draw the head. Okay, the head is like an egg shape. Modified sphere, the head is like an egg shape, it's a modified sphere. The breasts are modified sphere. The butts or the buttocks are modified sphere. Okay, the torso is a modified cylinder. The leg, the thigh, the calf, modified cylinder. Even the arms, okay, the arms are modified cylinder. Okay, and we talked about the feet and the hands, okay, as wedge shaped or modified cube. So once again, please like, share, subscribe. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section. Be waiting, okay? Stay tuned for my next video, okay? And till then, I remain La Contra. Ciao.